thing a World Cup can't do without? Grass, which isn't something easy to come by in the desert.
Welcome to Qatar's answer, their equivalent of the Field of Dreams. Over a million square metres of grass, or the equivalent of 168 football pitches a year.
The World Cup needs turf for 8 stadiums with 64 matches in just 28 days and an added 48 training pitches as well. The man whose job has been to make it all happen, Yasser Al-Mulla.
So I have to tell you, I have been through my career being told to get off the pitch, don't walk on the turf. And look at this.
You know why?
Go on.
Because they are not sure about their turf. Honestly, they're not sure about their turf. I can ask you, I will bring you a football here and I will tell you to play on it. And I will make sure that I can return it tomorrow to the stadium because I am sure about what I have here. This is the difference.
Yasser and his team started their quest to find the perfect pitch back in 2016. And they're certainly confident with what they've come up with.
What we have here is one of the best grass in the world. We reached this point by doing a lot of testing and experiment in the R&D center. So all the turf that you see here, we tried like 36 different kinds of species.
The promise of being able to relay a pitch in just 8 hours meant FIFA allowed the building of fewer stadiums than ever before at a World Cup finals. It's all part of Qatar's quest for a carbon neutral, sustainable tournament. That is easier said than done in the desert. But even the water for the pitches is part of the plan.
We are using a treated water, which has been never used before in the agriculture. So the treated station just like half a kilo from here. So that water was a loss because like we didn't have that much of agriculture culture in Doha. So we are using a treated water.
There's obviously a lot of science on show at the turf nursery, but if Yasser is to be believed, the secret of success is a whole lot more than that.
A lot of people, they think, oh, it's only like a green carpet. It's a living creature. Man, you have to take care about your lawn. Like, you have to understand. Sometimes this color telling you, it has no tongues and language. The pitch is talking to you, like the tree. The tree is talking to you by the yellowish. Like, I'm sick, I'm in a bad mood. It's not my season, my best season. So you have to feel it more.
From the desert to football's biggest stage. This might be the closest I get to the hallowed turf, but come next year, football's biggest stars will be putting on a show. Amanda Davis, CNN, Qatar.